truth and life. Here is the Brother Leon Show. You better recognize.
What's going on, listeners? This is your boy, Brother Leon, and you are tuning into another episode of the Brother Leon Show. Let's pray. Father, Lord God, we lift up those who have been affected by violence with the incident in New York, but also the incident in California. We ask right now that you will be with the family members and those affected. But also, Lord God, we ask that there will be legislation to address the problem of domestic terrorism on American soil. That there will be gun reform and control. And that firearms and assault rifles and weapons will not be so easily made available to those who have mental illness. I ask that there be reform when it comes to these gun shows. Even to the guns that can be created. I ask right now, Lord God, that you will begin to raise up a righteous politician who will not be bought, who will not be swayed, but that his heart is fixed, or her heart is fixed on taking away the burden and the yoke that has been on the American people and those affected by this violence due to the inactive course of our Congress at times, and those who stand for NRA and those who stand for gun rights, but will not say anything when we have tragedies and travesties like this. This is my prayer in the name of Jesus. Amen. I want to give you a scripture before I go in. I'm not going to be before you long. I'm coming out of Amos. Amos chapter 5. We're reading this from the ESV version. And we're going to start at verse 24. But let justice roll down like waters, and righteousness like an ever-flowing stream. And this is what we need right now. That justice and righteousness will roll. That justice and righteousness will be something that will cover us and protect us as a people. Because yes, we can have flag all day long. We can have politicians and people come to pray with us, but we need policy. And we need policy that is going to address the issues that face predominantly black people. I don't want to hear diversity talk. I need something for us as black people that's going to single us out and give us the type of protection that was given to our Asian brothers and sisters. That is what we need. Because the one thing that the Congress will not address, as well as the church, is the spirit and the rhetoric behind the creation of white domestic terrorists. Nobody wants to address it. Because the one thing that people are more concerned about is being reelected and trying to make America into this whole thing about apple pie land of the free, and that we could do better and be better. I look at the promises of Obama, and yes, that was a good dream. But the reality is what you saw on January 6th, the insurrection. The reality is what we have seen with Dylan Roof and this young man right here. The reality is Timothy McVeigh. The reality is rogue police. The reality is pastors and preachers who believe in individualism to come against this whole thing about racism and reconciliation without recognition. Recognition of the people that have been affected, black and people of color, but also recognition of the spirit that is behind and creates the white domestic terrorists. Nobody wants to address that. Nobody wants to do a study on that. But yet, let's ban these books. Let's come against critical race theory. Let's demonize and vilify Kevin Samuels because he's the reason. We need a scapegoat. And so we can blame it on woke culture. We can blame it on Kevin Samuels, whoever you want to blame it on. But at the end of the day, I'm tired of the good gestures. Yeah, you know what? I don't care about Black Lives Matter being painted or the banner flying anywhere if that don't mean nothing when it comes to my black body laying in these streets. Seriously. When I can finance my own oppression in a church, Black Lives Matter doesn't mean anything. I need policy. And I need to be made whole. So yes, I appreciate the fact that we have a black Supreme Court justice. I appreciate the fact that we have a black vice president. But we need an executive order, Mr. President. I'm going to tell you, pastors, don't be letting these politicians in your pulpit if they're not going to give you anything that's going to be primarily and predominantly for your community, especially if you're black. I mean that. Because I am tired of seeing everybody come to our church for a photo op and a book bag drive, but yet we don't get no ink. How is it I can get a picture? How is it I can get a sidewalk? How is it I can get a park? How is it I can get everything else except protection? Protection from these rogue police. Protection from these domestic terrorists. Because guns, they making it easy to get now. You can get a gun in Georgia without a license. Seriously. So I'm telling you right now, you better watch as well as pray. Especially if you living in these southern states. Because I'm telling you, man, there is people who want to flip the domino to start this race war, to start this class war. Why do you think that there is a shortage on a whole lot of stuff? And the stuff that ain't short, the price is so daggone high, it's ridiculous. Gas almost $5, depending on what state you live in. Shortage on baby formula. Meat prices done went up. So I'm telling you right now, man, you better prepare. And they say you shouldn't preach black liberation theology. No, they're trying to misconstrue and say black liberation theology is black supremacy, and it isn't. It's not that. We need to free ourselves from the promise that was told to us by our teachers. Who only gave us January 15th, Martin Luther King, I Have a Dream. But didn't give us the 68 or the 67 Martin Luther King. Who didn't tell us about Malcolm X. But we sang Our Country 'Tis of Thee, Sweet Land of Liberty, of Thee I Sing. And we pledge allegiance to the flag. But yet we're still not full Americans. We have to be exceptional to get half. And when we are exceptional and are accepted, at any given time, they can tell you who you are and throw you back into the label. It doesn't even have to be one on your level. It could be one that's ignorant. That's all it takes. So I'm going to tell you, man, wake up. Whether you're Christian or not, wake up. Because I'm going to tell you, I'm not going to vote just because you black. I'm not going to vote for you just because you Democrat or Republican, because both parties lie. they do not represent core values like it says it does. It goes where the money is. And that's how politics roll. It's about money. You got enough money, you can get anything passed. And that's the God knows truth. You're seeing it now. So wake up. Today we're going to end with Keep Our Love Alive by Stevie Wonder. It is appropriate for today. So if you haven't bought it, go out and get it on iTunes, because Stevie Wonder just celebrated a birthday. He is phenomenal, and I want to end it on that. You guys be blessed.
Says they can't when they're